Wednesday, the 5th of April 2006. The grand finale of the great show of 1001 Nights. The scene is set on the big open-air stage of the Gulf Resort of Doha, the capital of the Arabic Sheikhdom of Qatar. Received enthusiastically by 2,500 spectators, the 3-minute finale extends to a 20-minute encore show. The exuberance and high spirits of the 180 dancers from 57 different nations is a challenge to the soloists among them to perform ever new and more daring jumps. The fact that the greatest Arabic dance show could be transmitted live via the satellite channels of Qatar TV with one-day delay bordered on a miracle for all those involved. And the relief about the happy ending to a successfully survived adventure is written all over the faces of the most famous dancers of the world. But what happened that brought both artists and production team to the brink of catastrophe just 48 hours earlier? Let's flash back. 2 days earlier, the Riverdance ensemble had to break off the rehearsal due to a thunderstorm warning. Less than 5 minutes later, chaos breaks out. A tornado, wind force 12, coupled with torrential rain, drags half the stage down into the depths. The steel frames with the lights and the loudspeaker boxes snap like matches. Cameras mounted on stage a second ago are flung yards away. The morning after. This is to be the day of the live show. Now the extent of the tornado becomes apparent. It was the worst tornado Qatar, one of the most arid countries of the world, has ever experienced. Crisis management is what is called for now. After all dance ensembles agree to stay one day longer, the production team takes on the challenge. 36 hours remain for rebuilding the stage and for bringing in a fresh broadcasting unit and cameras. Only 2 hours to go before the live show starts. Now Riverdance continue the interrupted rehearsal. Only 1 hour to go before the live show starts, the German MDR TV ballet is starting the rehearsal for the very first time in Qatar. The first spectators are already taking their seats. The belly dancers of Night of Sultans concentrate on their remarkable choreography. They come right at the beginning of the show, which is to start in approximately 30 minutes. Inside the broadcasting van, the Qatari directors start the opening credits. The live show begins. We'll be right back. What a brilliant start. The most popular host of the country, Masuma Abdul Karim, welcomes the spectators together with a German-Turkish co-host, Errol Zunder, who already played the Shah of Persia in the international TV movie production called Saraya.
Shlonek, Mesa al Khair.
Hayakum Allah.
I have been told that that is Arabic for a heartfelt, a very warm, a wonderful welcome. There are so many elegant people here, and 1001 nights to me seems to be reality here, and not just a fairy tale. But that is only one picture of Qatar, the country of the future on the Arabian Gulf. The other pictures that have come to my mind are the smiles of the happy and satisfied people, the sea from three sides, nostalgia, the caravans in the desert, the camels, but also the great cars, petroleum, natural gas, not least the wonderful market of the world of the future. This is the exciting night of the sultans. And so, ladies and gentlemen, the night of the sultans. River dance, the flow of dancing, the flow of the river, dancing in a flow is what you might also say, dancing in perfection, completeness, supple, beautifully smooth, the feet clicking like drums on the floor. Somebody asked me before whether you can learn all this grace, all this poise. Well, my only answer is, I am afraid I can't learn it.
Well, not so bad at all. But here is the really thing, river dance, and it's their 10th anniversary. So let's join and celebrate.
Kate, Kathleena, Darren and David of the Riverdance group are visiting the famous souk of Doha, which, following its demolition, was rebuilt according to the traditional model. The Toby, the traditional headdress of the Qataris, is as fascinating for the dancers from Dublin as the black abaya of the Arabian women. Here, the time of 1001 nights seems to stand still. The fragrances from numerous spice shops seem to act as invisible magnets to our visitors from the Western world. Pepper, cinnamon, coriander, curry, caraway, the classic ingredients for traditional Arabic cooking. In front of the souk, there's the falcon market, today with specially reduced prices. For a one-year-old falcon, you pay 2,500 euros, and it is 35,000 euros for a well-trained animal. A change of scenery and a true contrast. We visit the biggest shopping mall of the Middle East on 100,000 square meters. Spread across five floors, there are 206 boutiques and luxury shops just waiting for your dollars and euros. And if you get hot, you can cool down on the ground floor ice rink. Even for the well-trained legs of the dancers, a shopping tour with such a vast array of goods is a mission near to impossible.
It takes the dancers several months to really learn a dancing number like this, and their training never ends. But despite this, a number of components must fit together perfectly to create a perfect dance show for a gala evening like this. But I have no doubts that this is perfect. Ladies and gentlemen, the German television ballet from MDR.
Strumming and clunking out of tune to beat the band. Dixieland. You make the cotton easy to pick. Rain, you give my old mint julep a kiss. Rain, who ever thought a Yankee would put a little Dixie Mouse to shame? You've made us feel alive again. You've given us the drive.
Qatar, the peninsula in the Persian Gulf, only a third of the size of Belgium and one of the richest countries in the world. The dancers of the German MDR-TV ballet want to take a boat trip. This is a cruise along the skyline of Doha, which will have grown by another 120 skyscrapers by 2010. Also worth viewing, the Palm Tree Islands, the ultimate holiday paradise of Qatar.
One Thousand and One Nights and Bolero. This piece, of course, is acknowledged as the erotic classic, and the Ballet Théâtre d'Espagnol will certainly confirm this. But of course it was a woman, a lady, prima ballerina Ida Rubinstein, who gave Maître Ravel the idea for this composition.
Of course, only a woman could have provided the right kind of motivation, idea. Rubinstein was a Ravel muse, as they say. And it took him 3 sleepless nights to compose the Bolero.
Even though Bolero was such a gigantic success when it premiered in 1928, Maître Ravel still belittled his most famous piece by saying, "Oh, this is just a simple orchestral exercise."
Thank you.
we go back to the afternoon before the great show. Master choreographer and double Oliver Award winner Dean Perry is getting his Australian tap dancers into the right mood for their performance. Since their debut in 1995, the Tap Dogs have been celebrating their phenomenal success in every capital city of the world. The boys from Down Under were the sensation at the opening ceremony of the 2000 Olympics in Sydney.
Tap Dogs?
The Tap Dogs. The boys from Down Under. They really will tap. And how? The Tap Dogs will jam. And that for you.
The desert of Qatar displays such a natural beauty which is unparalleled by any other part of the Arabic Gulf. Many motocross racers often train here for their world championships. The sand dunes with heights of nearly 40 meters offer another unforgettable adventure for motor enthusiasts. Dune bashing. Five plucky members of Night of Sultans accept the challenge and mount the hot racing quads, and off they go through the desert. The climate in Qatar is very hot and dry. In July, you have temperatures of more than 45 degrees centigrade. The expensive race camels of His Majesty the Emir of Qatar are not impressed. Falconry is an old tradition in Qatar. The nomads of the deserts were the first falconers. They trained the birds to catch the one or the other tidbit to enrich their owner's meager diet. The Arabian horses, admired all over the world, are the absolute pride of the Qataris. Dance has traditional roots in all Gulf states, not quite as vivacious as in our regions, more leisurely in nature. In the broadcasting van, the Qatari directors are watching carefully to get perfect shots of the more than 100 singers, dancers, and sword fighters.
So far, we have seen artists from Ireland, from Turkey, from Spain, from Australia, from our host country, Qatar. But the best thing you can do for your culture is look beyond your own horizon, to look at other countries, at other people, at other pots, as it were. And you will understand that I, as a gourmet, am now not quoting a philosopher, but rather a master chef, Paul Bocuse.
Errol, the expression multi-culture is pretty worn out by now, and yet, if ever there was a good example of culture, diversity, it has to be these young people, the dancers of the German TV ballet. The whole world's a stage and we're players on it. So better live your life and don't flaunt it. The WB, I bless tracks with a style. Lyrical firstborn with a gift of profile. A short path between the two doors, unlike anything you've ever seen before. Come right in and simmer, no thrills, it's cabaret. And you're bound to chill.
Sitting alone in your room, come hear the music play.
Yeah, the band playing.
Life is a cabaret, oh chum. Come to the cabaret. Put down the knitting, the book and the broom. Time for a holiday.
Smile away. Life is a cabaret, oh,
from stick to stone, realizing the lies that we're not the only ones. It don't stop, won't stop, can't break it. So might as well live love and don't fake it. But there's birds, bees, and miseries. Enough heads don't know Miss Liberty. So enjoy your stay, you're here today. Bon voyage, love.
Come taste the wine. Come hear the band. Start by admitting from cradle to tomb, his end that longest term.
Yeah, and here we go now.
Life is a cabaret, oh chum.
Say what?
And I love a cabaret, oh chum.
Say what?
Come to the cabaret. Cabaret.
Yes, say it.
The German Television Ballet.
Wenn ich jetzt sage,
stating, ladies and gentlemen, that we will now be seeing a flamenco, that announcement alone sounds so romantic. You can only enhance it all if the flamenco is danced by the Ballet Teatro d'Espagnol.
Sure, Aral. Flamenco doesn't need more explanation, and flamenco is a must in a such sitting like this and in this atmosphere, so sweet and so nice atmosphere tonight. And when it's been more and more with the ballet, Teatro Español performs it.
Yes.
The flamenco dancers of the Teatro Español Ballet got an invitation to visit the famous thoroughbred stud farm of the Prime Minister of Qatar. Already in the hall, they're very much impressed. The minister can take a look at his horses from the balcony of his office. These thoroughbreds belong to the best horses of the world. Last week, this white horse won the Great Championship of Dubai. It's not necessary to heat the swimming pool for the horses. The temperature of the water is about 25 degrees. After the daily training, every horse has to swim for 2 rounds.
Thank you.
I promise you, ladies and gentlemen, that now you will really be struck by thunder. You will really feel each beat within you. But that is not a threat, because now you can look forward to the powerful energy of the world-famous drummers from Japan, Yamato.
Errol, this is a music that steers the soul. Electrifying, explosive, a primeval power. The inexhaustible of energy of the young drummers beating their talk drums. This three strung drums of different size of covered with the hides of different animals.
The drum performance by the glorious 10 Yamato drummers has its cultural roots in Buddhism. Kaminari is the name of the program, and Kaminari is dedicated to the divine voices of thunder created by the explosive beats of talco drums.
The river dancers are visiting the private museum of Sheikh Ahmed bin Yasin bin Faisal Al Thani, the head of the government of Qatar. They're gazing at a collection of rare pieces, all from the exciting cultural history of Qatar, starting back in the Stone Age. But the greatest attraction of the museum is the extraordinary vintage car collection. The Emir owns more than 90 originals, but only one dozen of these cars are on display.
everyone is back.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yes. Let life go into your skin. That's the name of a song by Jim Morrison. One night? No. 1,001 nights in Qatar have now gone under our skin. The magic of encountering a distant country that has come closer to us.
Yes, Errol. Life and world without dance, that's mean a very big mystic. And wise man once said, and now let me add about that also, that without exposure to other culture, life would be a bring out joyless and boring.
Yes. Fremd bleibt ein.
Indeed, only what we disregard or overlook remains strange or alien. And our host, Qatar, has given us the key to better understanding of others.
Shukran, Qatar. Shukran, Sheikh Hamad.
Yes, Errol, I'm convinced that tonight's great dance show from Qatar, and it has helped to build a bridge between us and together. But we should know and keep in our mind that a bridge will always be built from two sides.
Yes.
Yes, and we can understand each other better if we only want to. Because this art of understanding one another better is like the art of these thoroughbred dancers from all over the world. There is no art without willpower and effort.
It's really difficult and very, very bad to say goodbye.
Well, I'm going to stay a couple of days longer, okay?
I will be leaving before you.
Yes, indeed, it is not easy to say goodbye. So my proposal is to say...
Auf Wiedersehen, arrivederci, addio, do svedanie, ma'al salama.
And let me say some words in a different language. Zayonara, ornagwa, shukran, hayakum Allah. As'adtuna, wannastuna, ma'al salama.
Mazuma Scheherazade.
Friends, Arab.
Thank you for this evening.